Radio 1, das Berlinale Radio.
Ellen Kuras aus Amerika. Sie hat mit Martin Scorsese, mit Michel Gondry gedreht und auch mit Spike Lee. Mit Gondry hat sie zum Beispiel Vergissmeinnicht gedreht, mit Kate Winslet und Jim Carrey. Und sie ist auch Oscar-nominiert worden für ihren Dokumentarfilm Betrayal. Jetzt ist sie in Berlin. Herzlich willkommen hier in Berlin, Ellen Kuras. Welcome hier in Berlin.
Danke, danke schön.
Sie sprechen sehr gut Deutsch. Wie kommt das?
Oh, jetzt habe ich alles mein Deutsch vergessen. Ich habe in Schule gelernt, aber nun.
Hört sich aber gar nicht so an.
I know, I try.
What is it like for you to be here in Berlin as a jury member?
I was in Berlin back in 1988, before the wall fell. I came here with a film made by Chantal Ackerman. Before I was even a camera person, I was producing her film. And then soon after I came here many years with a film called Swoon, with a film called Blow, with Spike's Summer of Sam. I mean, there's been many films that have been here, and I also brought my own film, which I directed, The Betrayal. So being here in Berlin, for me, is like coming back to a familiar place and familiar people. I've known Dieter for many years, and it's really a family here.
Your film Betrayal, you worked for this film 23 years, is it right? So it's really a project of heart, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, that film started out as a student thesis, which I started, and then it was difficult to finish that film because it was about Laos. And Laos was a country that was very close, it was communist at the time, still is. There was very little archival footage because the Americans classified the country as classified. It was secret. So it was very difficult to finish that film in the beginning, but you know, I never gave up on it, and in the course of making the film, I made 40 films in between. And so I finally decided, all right, I have to go back and I have to edit the film and just finish it. You know, I say to students and to everyone, it's like, even if you've been working on something for years, don't give up. You have to trust your inner voice, because it's really the only thing that you have, you know? You should know your craft and know it well, but also know about story, because I know a lot of students who come out of school and they know about the craft of filmmaking, but they don't know what they want to say. So it's important to learn to know about history, about literature, about what you want to say with your film.
Martin Scorsese, your last film, kind of a documentary.
It's a
monologue.
Yeah.
So what was challenging about this film project?
Well, you know, working with Marty has always been a huge pleasure. He is so funny, so incredibly smart, so incredibly knowledgeable about film and film history. It's amazing. I mean, he's like a walking encyclopedia. But, you know, he has such an incredible depth of mirth and humor. I just love working with him, and I will work with him anytime.
In your films, do you prefer moving cameras or static camera more? Or do you have a special thing you like very much?
People consider me a very, very good handheld camera person, which I appreciate. But, you know, I think it really depends on the story so much about how the camera moves. We were just discussing a film that we just saw about the camera work and about moving the camera and when you move the camera and when you don't move the camera. So for me, it's important that the camera be in either moving or non-moving according to what the story is. And also enabling the viewer to understand the story better.
For example, a documentary about Dieter Koslick. How would you film that?
Oh, on a long dolly track. And I'd be just going back and forth, following him on a long lens in between everybody. One would think you'd do it handheld, making circles around him. Yeah, I don't think I could keep up with him. I think I would need a Steadicam for that.
Yeah, he's really moving fast.
Yeah.
And is there something you are looking forward now at the Berlinale? Something special, a special event, or just meeting the other jury members? Or is there something special?
Well, you know, what's special for me is that I know a lot of people here. I already knew a number of people on the jury. And one person I really wanted to meet was Shirin. Not only because of her politics, but because her visuals have always struck me and I've always admired her work. We have mutual friends in common who have tried to put us together, so it's been fantastic being able to talk to her about art. And also I have many friends who are on the other juries and lots of friends who are in Berlin. So both from my commercial work as a director and also as a DOP and from working on the talent campus, I gave a lecture about four years ago, I guess, when I had my own film here. So for me, it's very exciting to be able to walk the red carpet in a different way. And, you know, I mean, it's all very exciting.
Thank you very much, Ankuras, and have fun here at the Berlinale.
Thank you.
Interesting people, you will, of course. And we are curious to see you tonight on the red carpet.
Yeah.
Viel Spaß.
Okay, thank you. Danke, danke schön.